Welcome back to the channel, you guys. Welcome back to Ironclad RC. I'm Big B. We got the Twin Hydro on the block, okay? This is a Delta Force Vortex 24-inch hydroplane. It's twin motor build. In our last episode, we epoxied the motors, the servo, got all the hardware installed, waterproofed, turn fin, everything. We left off when we started bending the stuffing tubes for the driveline. In this video, we're going to complete the driveline, cut the flex cables, get the stuffing tubes finalized and installed, and start and more than likely finish the steering setup. So stick around. Big B, Ironclad RC. This is part five, if I'm not mistaken. I'm kind of losing track here. So in part four, we drilled the through hole. We bent our stuffing tubes. Okay, we got everything mounted up. If you haven't seen that video, it's very informative. We did a lot of work in that one. Got the motors mounted up, holes drilled, everything. Okay, so little recap. I used a short piece of this 4mm cable. Cut to size in the coupler there, it gave me an idea where to put my through hole. Okay, you guys see that? Just marked the inside, drilled a hole through it, and then I made my cut forward on the inside and aft on the outside. Okay, I bent my stuffing tubes to match up, to meet up to the coupler, and basically it's where we're at now. Okay, so with this arrangement, I'm not using a Teflon liner. I find the quality of this cheap China stuffing tube and liner that comes with the 4mm cables to be dodgy at best. So I choose not to use it. I'm running no liner. So we're actually using a 7/32 main stuffing tube, KNS, links in the description. And I actually cut this shim off of the stock stuffing tube that came with the cables. Okay, I cut a shim off here, a shim off here, to shim up the stuffing tube going into the strut. Running no liner, use a smaller stuffing tube, and it's a little loose fitting, so you need to shim it up. And I cut this stuffing tube to size. I used a cutoff wheel, okay, and then I carefully filed the inside of this tube just enough that it fits over our main stuffing tube. Okay, I left that little flange on the end left over from our cutting wheel so that water deflects off of it, so it's hydrodynamic. Okay, you don't want like a factory cut end right here, because water will get caught in there and it'll actually push through the stuffing tube. So you want a nice tapered flanged end there. Okay, you guys see the difference? Okay, hydrodynamic, no drag, no lift, and that should work. All right, so we got our shim made. Now let's take that off and figure out where we need to cut this tube at. Alright, so I have that little short cable in there that's going to hold my stuffing tube in place for right now, just so we can mark where we're going to cut it. So I'm going to butt it all the way up to the coupler and then back off few millimeters. Okay, grab our marker. If you want it to go all the way into your strut, get you a spare brass tube, mark the end of your strut, put that mark on the end of the strut, and that's about how far your stuffing tube will go into the strut. Okay, see what I did there? I cut mine a little bit short. I really don't want it to go all the way in there, because these shafts or a little bit long. Okay, I need to keep this portion of my stuffing tube straight, which on a hydroplane you shouldn't be bending it back here anyway. You know what I'm saying? So yeah, I want this to kind of float in that shim. All right, so we need to do the same thing to the other side, or I guess, well, they're both the same, so I guess we could just cut it. And then I'm gonna cut it a little bit long first, and then we'll make another cut. Let's go in between our marks. I know I'm gonna cut it short, so let's go in between the marks so we don't have to pull it out, put it back in. A tube cleaner for cleaning out or cleaning off the end of your tube here. All right, use a tapered file in reverse. Forward, it'll just hook onto it. Do it in reverse, it'll clean it up pretty nice. Good to go. Let's slide one of them in. Probably gonna have to loosen up our strut here so we can get it in. I'm gonna go ahead and loosen this up, take it off real quick. Okay, so this should slide on there. Okay, yeah, that's perfect. All right, with our shim. Oh yeah, that's perfect, man. Leave our gap on the inside, about 4 millimeters should be good. All right, go ahead and get this other strut taken off. I think I am gonna go ahead and put my strut back on. Okay, we can flip it over and set it on the flat top, kick the rudder up and kind of see where our struts are. All right, I want them to be flat on this build here. I got my Mad Lizard ride height gauge here. We're just gonna kind of roughly just kind of see how high these ride pads are. It looks like about 17 and a half. This is an 18 millimeter mark. I made a 17, so I would say 17 and a half. So I'm gonna probably shoot for around, just by seeing that, no other measurements. Let's just do it 19. Let's start off at 19 millimeters on our ride height, just for the time being. It's not a final answer, okay? So at that 19 millimeters, we've got a lot of down angle on our struts here. Okay, so we need to, we need to get some of that down angle out. Okay, we need to get some of that down angle out. So what I'm gonna do is take these struts off. I'm gonna put, let's see. To get this to go flat, I'm gonna take a little bit of the bend out here and put a little bit of bend in it here, okay? All right. Okay, so I got you guys zoomed in here. Alright, this is the one I was just working on. I took some of the bend out up forward and put more bend in it toward the aft of the boat. So I don't know if you guys are gonna be able to see. Yeah, you can. See the two different cables there? See the bends different? That far strut, see the angle it's got on it? See this one's flat, relatively flat. So I'm gonna match that bend up on both of my cables. Got them matched up. All right, both of them are exactly the same bend. Exactly. So I got the servo out. I got my stuffing tubes roughed up where they're going through the hull for my epoxy. I triple, quadruple checked my fitment, my alignment. Okay, everything's good there. The bends, triple, quadruple checked. They're identical. Okay, on a single, it's not so hard, but this twin, it's very tedious. I've spent the last hour and a half making sure everything's right before I glue these in. So I'm using a 15-minute epoxy here, Bob Smith. Chose to use the 15-minute on my first application because I don't feel like waiting on this to cure all day. I want to get started on my steering. I'm also going to use a little bit of Cabasil, not much because it's like a light color and it won't look right on here. So I'm just going to use a little bit of Cabasil just to kind of fill in that void there, you know, nothing crazy. Thickened epoxy in. Okay, I got my gap right, my angles are right. I've been going back and forth, flipping the boat over, checking for the stuffing tube, make sure it's like straight with the hull and not like the bend's not cocked over to the side. I got my through holes started. I actually need to clean this up. I need to get on that because it's starting to cure out, so I'm gonna go ahead and work on this before it gets too far into the cure process. So they're basically tacky enough I can start working on the steering, and then we'll kind of come back to this. So I got my servo. Like I had mentioned in a previous video, I had built this, originally planned to put my servo on this side, but putting it on that side, it actually brings it, the servo arm, really far off center. So I chose to mount my servo like this. That brings it a little closer to center. We are going to need to put a bend in the steering arm. So I'm actually going to get this mounted up. Hadn't put connectors on my ESCs yet, so we're just going to use this little guy right here, a little 60 amp surpass, and hook it up to the receiver so we can work on our steering. That 60 amp ESC hooked up to a little battery, and I got my servo on it. My arm is straight up and down. I took the position of my servo arm into consideration. You know, if you want to mount the arm forward or aft, I'm gonna mount mine aft. And I got a couple of different options for my servo rod. Okay, we're going to use this bellow right here. This guy right here with this, either this one or this through hole. Pretty simple there. I have a 2 millimeter or a 3 millimeter option here. Captured ball end. It's a swivel ball end. So when this rudder kicks up, the swivel on the rod end should work. It should work, both of them. Okay, so this one takes a 1.5, I believe, and the rudder is already drilled out for that. This one takes a 2, and we'll have to drill the hole out larger. Okay, so kind of like thinking of which one I need to do here, which one I want to use, trying to keep trying to keep the boat light. I mean, I'm not going to really gain much weight from a servo rod, but trying to keep the back light as I can. We're definitely going to need to put a bend because my servo arm is higher than my rudder arm. You feel me? Now, I really don't like putting bends in my steering rods. I really don't. I try to line everything up for a straight shot. The way this boat here is set up, I doubt I'm going to be able to do that. I would have to have a laid down servo basically on the deck, and the way I wanted to set it up, it's raised. Now I could cut this hole right here. I could cut this hole right here off, drill a hole closer to center, and the bend in my rod won't be so bad. Okay, or it would be close enough to center on my servo that I would have a pretty good shot down. Now, if I did that, I would lose some steering throw, and I don't really want to lose a whole lot of steering throw. So, I think the bend is going to be the best bet, you know. So, we're going to run our linkage on the top. If I run it down here, I'm going to have to put a huge bend in it, and I don't want that. Very minute bend to get everything lined up. What I do is I kind of pick out which hole I'm going to use, okay? Get a judge of how high my ball end is going to be off the rudder, okay? And then basically a straight shot to the transom. You guys see that? Basically a straight shot to the transom and a mark where it's going to go through the hole. Okay, so I'm going to drill my hole right there. What I like to do is start off with a small drill bit. Okay, much smaller than the hole that I want to drill. That way I can at least get this rod through there, put the connector on my rudder, and kind of see where everything's going to line up at, you know? So right here, and then I can file it up or down. File it to size, you know. Okay, so now I can put this in. We need to actually scoot the hole over a little bit so it well, I don't know, we can run it on that inside hole. Yeah, we can run it on that inside hole, that'll be good. And so you see where my bend's actually gonna, it's actually gonna line the servo up height wise and side to side wise, you know. All right, so I'm gonna use a stainless steel through hole tube. It was actually one of the only tubes I could find that was the right size. I originally wanted to use this one, and it's smaller, and I could only get this linkage on the middle one where I had drilled my hole at. So I oversized the hole, found a tube that was going to work on there, and I can actually use my linkage on the outside or on the inside with no binding. Okay, so I think that's going to work. So what I've done is I made the hole perfect size. Okay, and what I'm going to do, I'm going to put my boot on first this time because I'm using a larger tube. And last time I used a larger tube, it took me like an hour to get the boot on. So I'm going to install that tube in my through hole with the boot on. It's going to make it easier. All right, just going to epoxy it into the boat. Nothing like silly or nothing. Little bit of thickened epoxy. Probably use 15 minute again, and boom, 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 it should be done. I got my through hole epoxied in the boat. Okay, I went ahead and put my connector on, just kind of making sure while it's curing out, making sure the tube is straight through the hole and we got plenty of throw. Okay, looks good. I can, like I said earlier, I can run it in the middle or the outside. We'll bend this in a little bit. Let's let this cure out a little bit more. It's tacky now, but that tube will move in and out if that rod gets pushed through that bellow and it catches or whatever. So let's go from the steering back to the flex cable and stuffing tubes. We're going to go ahead and cut our flex cable. Uh-oh. Oh man. I use those little stub shafts right here. Oh man. I gotta get these stub shafts out. Oh, that's gonna be a pain in the butt. Jeez. Well, that wasn't too bad. Wasn't too awful. Oh man, I spoke too soon. My viewers, Jamie Smith sent this cable to me. It's wire for push-pull steering. So I'm gonna try to get it in here. Push that cable out, hopefully. There we go. But it's a left-hand rotating cable, so I'm just using a cable that I know is left-hand. Check the rotation of the winds. They match up here, so this is my left-hand counterclockwise spinning prop, okay, on the right cable. Just want to make sure that they're matched up here. Got my clockwise spinning propeller. So do we want to run our props spinning outward, or do we want to run them spinning inward? Now, you know, that's a great debate. You know, there's lots of opinions on that. And I noticed whenever I run my propellers spinning inward to one another, my steering is more touchy. It tends to oversteer at times. And it's very, 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 finicky. When I run my props on my twins and the outward rotating, the steering's more like normal. It don't really tend to oversteer. If anything, it kind of understeers. Very stable with outward rotation. All right. And the steering's not quite as sensitive. So, I'm running my rudder forward of my propellers, okay? So we're running my rudder forward of my propellers. I feel we're going to need a little more steering, right? Because it's forward of the props, not aft. I did this on purpose. Well, for one, I want to see how it acts and how it steers. Two, I have a longer rudder I could put on it if it's understeering. And three, we can always extend it off the transom and get it back behind the props. Get a whole nother rudder blade, you know, and do that. But I feel it should steer okay if we run inward rotating props. We should get more lift. The steering should be a little more sensitive with the turn fin we're running, okay, with it inward, a little more steering, we should get a perfect turn with the rudder in front. That's what I'm thinking. I could be completely freaking wrong, but we won't know until we try it, okay? So, that being said, we're going to run inward rotating to start off with. I really prefer to run outward on this boat. I think inward may have too much lift. But again, we're just going to have to find out. What I like to do is just make sure the cables are pushed all the way forward. Okay, so we'll just mark that at the end of our strut on both of them. Okay, we'll pull this out. Get a ruler. Measure to our mark here. Okay, so it's 10 and an eighth here. All right, so we'll pull from the Teflon washer to the end of the cable. Our measurement we just pulled, so this is where we'll cut it. No torque roll. No torque roll with a twin. Come on. Okay, so I got the props shafts cut. All right. Boom, boom, boom. Got me a little gap there. I'll probably shave them down a little bit. But for right now, for this video's sake, that's good. We got our gap. A little more gap than what you need. You don't want the drive dog butted right up to the strut. You know, you need a gap for cable shrinkage. You know, that'll work. Oh, that looks good, boy. Yes, sir, buddy. All right, so we got the cables cut. We need to cut the slit for our drive dog. Probably gonna have to shave some of that grub screw off. So I got my 38 14s on here. These are gonna be great props for this boat. All right, we can fit that on. Let's make sure we can fit a 42-19 on. We got threads there, because if we didn't have threads on these high rake props, we would need to move this forward. I think this is going to be a good place for the drive dog, because I'm not going to have, for my shorter hubbed props, I'm not going to need to run like a spacer, you know. So let's try the 17-17s. That looks good. And a set of 17-16s here. Yep, this is a 17-16. That's going to work. And a 16-16. Yep. All right. We're good. We're good. We are good. Okay. Man, look what that salt water does to my props. Look at that. That's terrible. I can never keep a nice looking prop. Look at that. A drop of water dripped on it the other day. Look at that. Okay. So that's where we're going to run our prop. That's the back of our prop. So we're going to put our drive dog right there. Yeah, that looks about right. Okay. Boom, boom, boom. Okay. And the drive dog goes over that. I actually need to pick up some Loctite. I got to go through and Loctite my whole boat. I don't have a drop of Loctite right now. Well, I do, but it's pretty much gone. I might have a drop left. Yeah, that's going to work perfect. So I'm going to do the same thing to the other prop shaft. It looks like we don't need to take our grub screw length down. It's kind of tucked in there. Boom, boom, boom. The drive line's done. Got our slits cut for the props. Cables are cut, soldered. It's done. So now we need to bend this steering rod. Okay, so what I'm doing is I'm gonna put a mark on my rod here. Okay, and I'm gonna move this back and forth, kind of see where that mark is in my boat. Okay, so I think I'm gonna bend it here, and I've got to only bend it up a slight amount to make it to my servo. Okay, we're on the home stretch. Yes, sir, freaking buddy. I appreciate you guys watching this extremely long video. I got the steering rod in. Got it hooked up here. Just kind of see what the movement looked like. It looks good. I need to I need to go back on my dual rate, but just for initial setup, it works great. I made a long bend here, so I didn't have to do like a 90. I did more of a 45. Okay, I need to go through and Loctite everything. I haven't used any Loctite yet, so we'll do that here shortly. Drive dogs are cut. I cut them a little farther forward than I wanted to, so we'll have to run a washer. Everything's done. Pretty much done in the drive line. I could grease it and spool it up right freaking now, you know. But I'm going to wait, okay? All we got left to do is the ESCs, get connectors on there, figure out what we're going to do for water cooling, get everything, the batteries situated, and take it for a freaking maiden. It's getting close, you guys. So thanks for watching. If you guys learned something or you found this video interesting, hit the thumbs up, like, comment, subscribe, and ring the notification bell. Get notified for future builds. We'll see you next time. Thanks for watching.